They got to go. Remember an interview just a week or so ago with CNN's Dana Bash, he said they got to go, but then we'll let them back in, the good ones, on an expedited basis. To most conservatives, that's amnesty. So we're beginning to get more specifics from Mr. Trump. They help him or hurt him, I guess, is the question.
Well, the fact that this immigration plan is coming and that he's working with Jeff Sessions on it, reportedly, this has been independently verified by others, but you know, that suggests that he's coming down with a really hardline plan that went nowhere in Congress, despite decent vocal support for it. But again, it shows you, once again, he is taking a serious step. We didn't think he'd run, he ran. We didn't think he'd release his financial reports, he did. Now he's releasing policy specifics, starting with the one that got him on the front pages to begin with. We'll see if there's a tax plan, if there's foreign policy conversation. But it does suggest that, despite all the sort of eye-rolling we have about it, he is starting to take steps.
How much do we trust that they're actually his plans, though, when if they release a white paper, and then when you the interview there, as you saw with Chuck and other people have been through this, you ask him questions. We'll do it. We'll just do it. We'll work with them. We'll get it done. Without explaining what agency of the federal government might do this or how much money it will cost taxpayers. People are buying it so far, but there it's a little rough to say, what are you going to do?
Right. I think so far he's had a lot of just benefit of the doubt, you know, people coming to his events because they love his style and sort of the surface level, you know, oh, I want to see the person who is the host of The Apprentice. Now, as we get, you know, further into the cycle, I think people are going to be pressing him on specifics. But the people that do turn up to his rallies, I think the, you know, last two, three events that I went to that he was hosting, people do want to be there because of the celebrity factor. Mm. But I think the question for a couple months down the road is, you know, the people that currently say they support him, when do they decide that they're sort of done with the fun and the fact that he's an interesting candidate and a different candidate, and when do they decide this is not actually someone that I think belongs in the Oval Office?
Right. At the moment, they're deciding, if you look at the latest poll we have out in Iowa, at the moment they're deciding Mr. Trump is their front runner. 22% in Iowa, Carson at 14, Walker at 9, Cruz at 8, Fiorina at 7. One thing this Iowa poll tells you, number one, Mr. Trump is getting a lot of conservative votes right now. Conservatives say he's not one of us. He's a fraud, the conservatives say, but a lot of conservative writers and analysts, but he's getting conservative votes. That's a conservative field, plus the outsiders. Carson doing well there as well. But let's flip to New Hampshire. If you look at New Hampshire, Trump's still on top here. This is a bit more traditional. If you look at the New Hampshire numbers, then you go Bush, Kasich, Cruz, Fiorina. That's a bit more, you know, the guys who have titles, John Kasich being one of their 12%, they're doing a little better in New Hampshire.